Once there was a poor peddler who lived in the old English town of Swaffham. Every day he walked out of his cottage door, past the great oak tree that grew beside it, and sold wares from the knapsack he wore on his back. His little dog would follow, yipping at his heels. Everyone knew when the peddler was coming, for he sang. Knick-knacks, bric-a-bracks, fine and shiny things, come and buy my fine shiny things. Some days he sold enough to buy himself a loaf of bread for his dinner and a bone for his dog. But there were many nights when he went to sleep hungry. One such hungry night, he had a dream. In the dream, he heard a voice. It said, "Go stand on London Bridge and you will hear good news." In the morning, he remembered his dream. As he walked out of his cottage door, past the great oak tree that grew beside it, he wondered, what could a dream like this mean? The next night, he had the same dream. Once again, he heard the voice. "Go stand on London Bridge and you will hear good news." In the morning, he remembered the dream again. As he walked out of his cottage door, he leaned up against the oak tree and wondered, what could a dream like this mean? On the third night, when he heard the voice again, "Go stand on..." he sat bolt upright in his bed and decided to go to London in the morning. He set out at dawn, knapsack on his back, little dog at his heels. As he walked down the road with a skip and a whistle, he sang a new song. He made it up as he went along. As foolish as it seems, sometimes it's wise to follow your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams, your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams, your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams. He walked and he walked and he walked for a week. At last, he arrived in the royal city of London. In these olden times, London Bridge was a great stone expanse with shops lining its sides. He went directly to the middle of the bridge, and just as the voice in the dream had instructed him, he and his little dog just stood there, waiting for good news. He stood all day. He stood all night. He stood through the rain till the sun came out. No one stopped to speak to him. Finally, a shopkeeper, who had been watching him the whole time, approached the peddler and said, "Pardon me, sir, but I've been watching you from my shop window for days now. I am curious to know what you are doing on London Bridge. You don't sell anything, and I haven't seen you beg. Yet you stand here day after day. What are you doing on London Bridge?" The peddler blushed and said, "I hardly know you to tell you such private things, but then again, you are the first person to speak to me since I arrived in London, so perhaps I will tell you. Sir, I had a strange dream for 3 nights. Each night I heard a voice which said, 'Go stand on London Bridge and you will hear good news.' Now, I know this doesn't make much common sense, but sometimes common sense makes no sense at all. I am a man of feelings. I felt I should come, and that is why I stand on London Bridge. The shopkeeper began to laugh. He laughed so hard he had to hold his belly. He laughed so hard a crowd gathered to find out what was so funny. "Listen to this," he said to the crowd. "Here is the biggest fool you will ever meet. He is standing on London Bridge because he heard a voice in his dream." Everyone in the crowd began to point at the peddler and call him a silly fool. "Silly fool, silly fool, silly fool. Look at that silly fool." But the peddler just stood there. When he didn't move, the shopkeeper, enjoying the taunting, drew the crowd in even tighter and said, "Following dreams! What a foolish man you are! I had a dream just last night. I dreamt of a place I've never even heard of. Swaffham, I think it was. I dreamt that if I dug in the ground in front of an oak tree that grew beside a poor peddler's cottage, I would find a treasure. Now, do you think I would be foolish enough to leave my home and my work to follow some silly dream? Do yourself a favor, sir, and go back from where you came." The peddler's face spread wide with a smile. "I certainly will go back," he said, and ran all the way home to Swaffham. When he arrived at his cottage, he took a shovel and began to dig in the ground in front of the oak tree he knew so well. Sure enough, he found an iron box. When he pulled it up out of the hole and brushed away the soil, he saw that there were words inscribed on its lid which said, "Travel far, travel wide. The greatest treasure is deep inside." He opened the box and saw that it was filled with gold and jewels. He gave half of the treasure to the poor, for he himself had known hunger. And with the rest, he built a church, which stands to this day with a statue of the peddler and his dog. There was enough gold left over so that the peddler and his dog lived comfortably for the rest of their lives. As he walked down the road with a skip and a whistle, people often heard the peddler singing. "As foolish as it seems, sometimes it's wise to follow your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams, your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams, your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams, your dreams. Follow, follow your dreams."